Welcome to this lesson. We have created all particle elements and the animated ship geometry, which can be used to create the cloudscape. So let's bring all these elements into the clouds network and create one volume. So the particles which we created previously, if we put them through the clouds network, this will be the result in the UI which we will see. And I can see the particles from the ship are currently a little bit dense and too big in shape. So let's dive into this network and create separate streams for each element so that we can adjust those. Now I'm gonna make a little bit more space here and remove the volume visualization node. I will plug it in later. So now copy paste all these nodes. And when you middle mouse click on the in-cloud particles, we should get like 2 point groups from the clouds and one from the ship. So I'm going to remove the points from the ship for the first stream and leave the stream as it is. And in the second stream, I'm going to remove the clouds. So I'm going to rename the set P scale here to set P scale clouds and the other one to ship. Now when I select the P scale ship, now I can go in here and adjust a little bit the ease in and out for the P scale so that this is happening later and the other one is happening earlier on. That will reduce the size overall, the lifespan, and I will multiply the general P scale with 0.2. So I need to increase the minimum, decrease the minimum P scale maybe as well. And I'm gonna keep less of them overall. So let's scroll to this attribute P scale and copy this parameter into the minimum radius of the VDB from particles. What I want to do is link from the first VDB from polygon the voxel size and create a reference in here. And I'm going to increase the voxel size by multiplying it with 0.8. Now after the VDB from particle, I'm gonna drop a VDB smooth. And use two iterations. Now the volume bob. I leave it like that for now. And the next thing would be the cloud noise. Now let's adjust that one. Remove the advection noise and reduce the amplitude and the octaves as well. And maybe increase a little bit the roughness. And once that's done, let's display the cloud noise. So this would be the result for the cloud noise of the points from the ship. And as a next step, let's bring in the geometry of the ship. So I'm gonna fetch from the animation ship, the out animation ship, and rename the sub to in animation ship. So the next thing, going to drop a VDB from polygons, create an SDF surface, and I'm gonna copy paste the settings from the first VDB and reference them back in, and this time increase the resolution again, but use a multiplier of 0.6. Now I'm gonna use the VDB reshape. And extend it by half a voxel. Now the next step, I need to convert it. And I'm going to change from SDF to FOG. So then this volume has to be renamed to density. And this is the one which can go into the cloud noise. So I copy paste the first one, paste that in, connect it up to the ship geo, and display that one. Now let's have a look at the result, and our ship will look something like that from the geometry. Now all these elements which we created, we can combine them using the VDB combine, and the option for that would be add, since it's containing density values. And I'm gonna drop another one, so I can actually copy paste them with the same settings. And inside here, for the resample, I choose to match A to B, match B to A. So whatever comes in here, we will have the same resolution as in the first stream. Now after this VDB combine, I'm gonna put the volume visualization node, and I will view the final result from the VDB combine. So I'm gonna put that on automatic. So this is the current volume. And let's have a look through the camera. Now let's check again the settings of the cloud noise for the ship geometry. So currently I haven't changed the cloud noise from the ship geometry, and I would like to adjust first the noise options. And I'm going to change the amplitude to 0.7, and octaves are gonna leave at 4. The element size are gonna change to 4, just slightly smaller shapes. I'm gonna increase the roughness here, and then go to the edit vector tab. Change here the amplitude to 4, the element size to 5. Just a few settings which you found early on. And after that, I'm gonna go to the cloud light and visualize this one. Let's see how that looks like now. So I'm gonna open the UI. So this is the current result we have from the clouds. And if I turn around to see how it looks from the different angles, I think this is better than the first result. And with all the streams, we can now adjust each of them in particle size, scale and density. So the next would be to go and try render that and adjust the shader and tweak shaders, and yeah, let's see how that goes.